What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today I'm going to be covering how to make this really subtle but really cool effect that I use in a lot of my music videos, in a lot of my skate edits, and a lot of my creative videos. So the great news about this effect is you don't need to use After Effects or download any third-party plugins. You can use the Wave Warp effect directly in Adobe Premiere Pro. I'm going to show you what that looks like. Let's hop right into it. So with this example, I have some footage from a music video I shot about 2 years ago with this rapper called A1 Dre. The video is called Up Now. It's on my YouTube channel if you want to check it out. But basically, I have marked here the different spots where I use this Wave Warp effect. You see these lines that kind of come across the screen, and it's kind of like separating body a little bit. It's making it look kind of trippy. You know, you can see here I'm using it on some drone footage. You can see where the line is, the tracks are separating, and it just kind of gives it like this trippy look, this trippy vibe. A really clean effect, and I really do use this effect on a lot of my projects. So check it out one more time in full motion. In order to do this effect, let's just copy this clip right here. Come to your effects tab in Premiere Pro, type in Wave Warp right here under Distort, pull that onto the clip. Now it might start out like this, so we gotta come over to the effects tab, change it from sine to square. I also really like the smooth noise, is really cool. Mess around with these, but for this example, we're just gonna be using the square. And then from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna change this from 10 to, let's say, 15. And then wave width to something way higher. So like, let's do 675. And now you can see we have like these big blocks that are cut out of our clip. From here, what you wanna do is I usually slow the wave speed down. So if I play this, you can see how fast they move. So that's pretty cool. I like to slow it down a little bit, so we'll go to like 0.3 for that one. And then you can also change the direction of which they go. Now you can also keyframe the direction, which is really cool. So, you know, if I wanted it to kind of rotate around the screen, you could hit this keyframe here in the very beginning. Let's come a little bit farther towards the end of the clip. See where those lines are. Now we can rotate the lines a little bit. Give it a nice keyframe. Instead of it just going like up or down or left or right, we can kind of have it like kind of tripping out across the entire screen, like rotating more like a wheel or something. I don't know, however you want to describe that. And then what I would like to do is change this pinning to all edges. This gets rid of the black bars you see around the sides. And now you have like this clean effect right here. I don't really mess with the phasing at all, but you can. And then the anti-aliasing, I usually turn that up to high just so that it's the best quality. And then boom, that's what we get. So I did also use this effect in one other music video around this same time period. So I'm going to show you guys an example from this other music video as well, just so you can see kind of another example. So check it out. So it's really subtle right here, guys. You know, you can see it right here, and it kind of just climbs through this screen right here. So check this out. So I just think it's a really good effect to have in your bag for any type of edit, really, but especially creative edits. So definitely check this one out next time you're throwing a music video or a creative edit together. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch my video. If you're interested in learning more about digital assets like video overlays, transitions, that sort of thing, check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I got a few free things on there that you can use for your own video edits. It's pretty cool. I use a lot of that stuff that I make on my own video edits, so definitely check that out. And if you like this video, make sure to click that like button down below. Subscribe to the channel, I'm really trying to grow and just create more video editing tutorials. If you have any other questions, let me know down below. I'll be happy to answer them. And until next time, I'm Jake. Peace out.